Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Arbaeen is the world's largest annual gathering and is truly a demonstration of love, generosity, commitment and determination towards the brilliant mission and the movement of the grandson of the Holy Prophet Hussein ibn Ali salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. But what does the number 40 signify? Why Arbaeen? Why 40? Of course, if you look at the number 40 in the Holy Quran, you recognize that it has a special significance. For example, in chapter 2, verse number 51, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ وَعَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً, that Musa, the great prophet of God, peace and blessings be upon him, went towards the Mount of Sinai for 40 nights to receive the communication from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Similarly, in chapter 46, verse 15 of the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حُسْنًا حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ كُرْهًا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهًا وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ 30 شَهْرًا حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَبَلَغَ 40 سَنَةً. Quran says that the age of maturity for the human being is 40. And similarly, in chapter 5, verse 26, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds and tells people regarding the Bani Israel that they had to travel throughout deserts and throughout lands for 40 years. Now, of course, if you look at the narrations from the Holy Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, you'll find also some significance paid towards the number 40. Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in Al-Kafi volume 1 page 49 says, whomsoever from my ummah memorizes 40 hadiths which they will benefit from will be resurrected by Allah on the day of Qiyamah as a knowledgeable scholar. Similarly, the Prophet of Islam had mentioned that in a hadith that if a person reaches the age of 40 and does not seek repentance, tawbah, shaitan will wipe over their face and hands and says, surely a face that will not succeed. Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi in Wasa'il al-Shia'a volume 7 page 103 says, if 40 people gather together and supplicate to Allah for the fulfillment of deeds, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to them. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam also says that when a believer dies, 40 believers should gather together and attend the funeral and say, Allahumma inna la na'lamu minhu illa khayra. Oh Allah, we don't know anything about this individual except good. And then he says, upon this Allah will reply, I have accepted your witnessing and have indeed forgiven him for that which I know and you do not know. Narrations tell us from the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam that sprinkling the grave with water for 40 days is indeed highly recommended. It's a hadith from Wasa'il al-Shia'a volume 2 from Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam. Sincerity for 40 days is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed wisdom in the heart of a believer, according to a narration of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam in Bihar al-Anwar, that whomsoever displays ikhlas for 40 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place wisdom in their hearts and make it ooze from their tongues. And so we have these narrations regarding the number 40, but specifically when it comes to Imam al-Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him, there are a number of interesting narrations that point to the significance of number 40 and Sayyid al-Shuhada. One of them is found, for example, in the works of Ibn Kuthayr or Ibn Kathir, Al-Bidayah wa Al-Nihaya, which says that water at one stage was running over the grave of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam to the extent that the grave was concealed, but after 40 days the water dried. And a Bedouin from Bani Asad came to the grave thereafter, took part of the soil, began to weep and said, may my mother and father be sacrificed for you, how pure you are and how your soil is fragranced. Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, in a narration in the book Kamil al-Ziyarat, says that he addresses Zurara and says, oh Zurara, the heavens wept for Imam al-Hussein for 40 days. The earth wept for 40 days in darkness. The sun wept for 40 days through an eclipse. The mountains crumbled and exploded. The angels cried for 40 days over Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. But of course, the famous narration from Imam al-Hasan al-Askari, peace and blessings be upon him, which is found in numerous books of narration, including Bihar al-Anwar, identifies five essential qualities, characteristics of a believer. These signs are indicative of the individual who's considered a mu'min. And of course, Imam al-Askari alayhi salam says, the signs of the believer are five. One of them is al-jahar bi bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, to recite the bismillah loudly. The other is to have a ring on the right hand. The third is prostration on the soil. The fourth is to recite 51 rak'ats daily. And of course, the fifth is ziyaratul arba'een, the ziyarah of the 40th of Imam al-Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. And therefore, number 40 occupies a very important position. There is a secret behind number 40. And today, the millions who walk from different cities around Iraq towards the city of Martyrs Karbala is an indication of the divine blessings and the divine support for this important sha'ira, this sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a wonderful symbol for mankind to learn and to benefit and to indeed participate and see the excellence of. Ooh.